Let's go back, and I'd like to start off with the introductions. Dr. Thompson, would you please introduce yourself and talk about your program? Thank you.
Absolutely. Hi, everybody. I'm really, really happy to be here. My name is Caitlin Thompson. I'm a clinical psychologist by training. I work for the VA. I've been working in the suicide prevention field for the last 9 years, and I oversee the VA's suicide prevention program, which is an integrated network and an integrated, it's one of the largest integrated suicide prevention programs really in the world. I'm really happy to talk about it more, but again, I'm very happy to be here. Thanks for having me.
Thank you. We'll just go straight to Wendy Laxo, please.
Hi, yes, thank you for inviting me. We're excited to participate in this program and this event. So I'm Wendy Laxo. I'm the chief of the Army Suicide Prevention Program. I've actually been in this position for only 1 month and 1 day, so I'm still learning, but just to let you know, the Army's efforts to reduce the incidence of suicide are aligned with our comprehensive approach of its Ready and Resilience strategy, which synchronizes and integrates total Army resilience programs to strengthen our Army and really sustain a supportive environment that enhances resiliency through integrated training, of which suicide prevention will be part of that holistic integrated training. So it just emphasizes that early intervention and those prevention efforts. And we're working with DOD in order to do that with the services too. So that's it. Thank you very much for the invitation.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much for joining us. And Ms. Garrick, would you please tell us about your program?
Hello, thank you for including us today. I'm excited to be participating in this forum. I've been working with veterans and military community for probably 30 years and started working with the Defense Suicide Prevention Office when we stood it up almost 3 years ago now. So we had a report that documented some issues with the way the DOD was handling suicide. And for the last 3 years, we've developed an effort to standardize, centralize, oversee, and communicate best practices in suicide prevention across the department. So that's been my role. That's what we've been doing. And we've made, I think, some progress in reaching some of our goals. So I'm excited to get an opportunity to talk about those today. Thank you.
Thank you. And Stephen Wolf and Adrian Adesado, would you please introduce yourselves and talk about what DAV is doing in this area?
Good afternoon. My name is Stephen Wolf. I'm an Assistant National Service Director with the DAV. We're located in Washington, D.C. at our National Service and Legislative Headquarters. I provide direct oversight of roughly 270 National Service Officers nationwide. We also have transition service officers located at military facilities across the country. We have outreach programs, homeless programs, voluntary services, and we represent with our National Appeals Officers located here in D.C. as well.
So what Stephen was talking about, our service program. So these officers, these National Service Officers, Transition Service Officers, and Chapter Service Officers, they're actually kind of like a hub-and-spoke model. If a veteran comes to us and need help with regards to benefits from the federal government or state government, these individuals are main service providers for those veterans in the field. My name is Adrian Adesado. I'm the Assistant National Legislative Director for DAV. I oversee the healthcare portfolio and manage our health policy positions when it comes to Department of Veterans Affairs as well as legislation that goes through Congress.
Thank you very much. And then last but certainly not least, I'd like to introduce Warden Goldstein. He's with the American Legion. He's the Assistant Director for TBI and PTSD program. Warren, would you go ahead and tell us about yourself and your program?
Yes, thank you very much. My name is Terry. My name is Warren Goldstein. I'm the Assistant Director for TBI and PTSD programs for the American Legion. Thank you very much for this opportunity. On behalf of our 2.4 million members, we want to thank you for this opportunity to come talk about how important this topic is, not only to the American Legion, but to the country as a whole. My role at the American Legion is really to manage the TBI and PTSD programs within the Veterans Affairs and Rehabilitation Division of the American Legion. The division really manages the claims and benefits as well as the healthcare portfolios for veterans and their families. My role is to really look at the existing science and alternative therapies for treating TBI and PTSD. Again, thank you for this opportunity, and I look forward to this forum.